Have this workspace in here. This is how exactly, this is where exactly you'll be getting your error messages if there are any errors. So now we start with the Fluent software. We click on right click, and your analysis system, whatever your analysis is. In this case, we have Fluent. You can always also opt for new component system. If you have already made the mesh, you can import it in Fluent software directly. You don't have the mesh in this case, so we'll be first making the geometry, then proceeding towards the mesh, then the Fluent software. So now we go for Fluent. This takes a bit of a while. It consumes very high RAM, as well as your processor speed should be very high. The analysis system will be 2D as the computer. We need to reduce the computation space. So we go to right click, properties, geometry, the analysis. So computational time is saved if you do it by 2D analysis. So we have 2D in here. This is how exactly we'll be proceeding. First the geometry, then the mesh, then the setup. Solution results. Once the geometry is 2D, we can proceed towards making the geometry. Now you should always double click on the model kit's text and starting design modeler. This exactly is a status bar. You can see what exactly is happening in here. Is this the system busy or not? The starting design modeler, it is starting the geometry part. Yes, we have opened the geometry part. The working directory would be millimeters. Let me tell you some flow physics. The dia of the cylinder would be 1 mm, and the Reynolds number would be 17.1578, as the velocity would be, velocity is 1/4 m/s, that is 0.25 m/s. So I've already calculated the Reynolds number by the formula rho v d by mu. By this formula I've calculated the Reynolds number, and we'll see the flow physics at this Reynolds number. So let's begin with the geometry. In this software, basically the flow happens from x towards the x direction. As the geometry is 2D, we select the xy plane, okay, and we move it towards the normal side. This by this option, it says look at the face plane as sketch. So okay, now we have the geometry in here. We go for sketching. We need one circle at the center. Now we have the circle. Then we need a rectangle over it, which will act as a domain. So we also have a rectangle. Now we will proceed towards the dimensions. So we need diameter. We need to define the diameter of the cylinder. Then later length and distances for the rectangle. So this exactly is the length. They want to align it with the center, so this specifically will have how much distance from the center line. Now I've given some dimensions. I redefined the dimension. The diameter should be 1 mm. Done. Line 2. This is line 2. Let me make it as 100 mm. So we have 100 mm from here. Line 3. Line 3 will act as 50 mm. So we have the domain in the space. domain should be specifically bigger, huger than the body dimension. Line 4, this line is very specific as it is a subsonic to the disturbance. The disturbance in here can be seen over here. This equation, the CFD software will be using elliptic form equation, so disturbance at this point can be sensed at this particular region. If it is an hyperbolic equation, hyperbolic partial differential equation, as in case for supersonic flows, the disturbance in here is not felt in here. The area of influence is the backside. So we, as the flow space physics says that the domain should be higher at this point, so we will be making it. So let us make it as 75 mm. 75 mm should do. 75 mm seems to be good. I will make it as 50 mm. Okay, 60 would be fine. So we have 60 and we have over here this 122. We make it to be 150. As you need to see the weight region in this area, so we need some space in here also. So 150 would be just fine. So now we have the sketch. Let us make it as a surface. For the making of the surface, go to concept. Surfaces from sketches. We have one, then take to sketch one. This will sketch the entire sketch. Apply. Generate. You always click the generate button for generating it. You see, we have an hole at the center, the circular diameter. The hole is actually the solid part, and the shaded region acts as our domain, as a computational domain. So we are interested in this, not the inside part of the cylinder. We always save the file because this consumes a lot of RAM. Your computer may hang, and you may lose some data. So it is advisable that you save the file every time when you work, so the next time you can open it. Now I've saved the file, it is saving it, project ready. Now we proceed towards making the mesh. So first we'll give the name selection. This is point selection, this is edge selection, this is face, and this is the body. We'll select this edge. We'll keep this circle inside and give this as create name selection. We take one line, then we press Ctrl to select the others. So we have this create name selection. This is just a wall outside, and yeah, this is the inlet. So before, you should always keep in mind that the name you are giving it should be in the reference of the not the physics. The software is specifically name sensitive, because I'm giving it as an outlet, the boundary condition will take it as outlet. So you cannot give the name as inlet to outlet and keep in your mind that the inlet is the outlet and the outlet is the inlet, because in the boundary condition, as we say, as we'll be seeing further, it will be taking the name as outlet as the outlet. So your physics might be reversing. So you should always keep in mind what exactly you are giving as a name selection. This name selection we are basically giving it because the software has to understand what exactly is it. So now we are doing the name selection, we proceed towards the mesh. The mesh, we click this button, I'll generate mesh. We can make a structured mesh, unstructured mesh. This is completely unstructured mesh. This is by quadrilateral dome. Quadrilaterals. Let us make it as okay, for the mesh we'll proceed as insert method. We'll select this body, go for auto method is not automatic. Apply. It's not quadrilateral, it has to be triangles. Great. So we are making unstructured mesh using triangles. You can also make a structured mesh, but it consumes a lot of time. You should be proficient in making it. So now, saving time, will be just proceeding towards making the triangular mesh. This is how exactly it will look like. This is actually a post, we will make it a bit medium. So this is how exactly your mesh will look like. Now you can also control its growth rate. This 1.2, you can make it to 1.001, whatever it is. And you can also change the minimum maximum size in this. So this parameter will change the mesh size, the edge length, the everything it will change. So minimum edge length you can change it to this order of e raised to minus 3, you can make it to e raised to minus 5, e raised to minus 4, e raised to minus 6, e raised to minus 7. This will basically depend on how exactly your RAM. If your RAM is good, you can make it, otherwise this will consume a lot of time and your system will get hanged. So you should always keep in mind this point. Once this is done, we make the refinement layer in here. So mesh, right click, insert, refinement is, and we select this edge. Update. Refinement is very important because with the mesh, there has to be more number of nodes in here. So this will transfer the physics towards the other part. Let's see how it's added the mesh. So we have three refinement layers in here. This is the refinement layer over the cylinder. So the mesh is done, the nomenclature is also done. We save this file, save project. To work towards the setup and the print software. So So geometry is done, so it will put a tick. Mesh is done, it will put a tick. Setup is to yet to be done, so it will put a tick. So remove this step. If you have parallel processing capacity, use parallel, otherwise serial is gonna. Double precision is possible at certain points, you need double precision. Second order differentials to solve. So you go towards this. So now this is how exactly the fluent will look like. This is the mesh, this blue part is the inlet, this is the outlet, this is the wall, this is the cylinder wall. We have this, we will be solving towards steady state, so let it be steady state. We have 2D planar, neither do we have axisymmetry nor axisymmetric solve. Gravity, we don't need gravity in this case, velocity would be absolute. So we check the mesh port. We should check the mesh is done. Energy, we don't need energy equation in this case. Viscous should be laminar as the flow physics says. We don't need any other part. So now we, from models, we proceed towards materials. Materials would be air. Spray chain. So yes. Okay. Material is air. Change create. That is done. Yes. You can, if you want to change the material, you can use the fluent database also. Cell zone condition we don't need. Boundary condition, cylinder wall, this wall, you see the name in your wall says it is a wall, so the naming is also very important. This will be a stationary wall with no slip condition. Thermal, we don't have temperature anywhere, as the it will say it is not applicable because the energy equation is switched off. Inlet, so this velocity inlet, edit, it will be normal to the boundary, the velocity was 0.25 meter per second, it should be constant. The outlet has pressure outlet, we have to swallow a radiator, give us a slip condition towards to the wall, we have to specify shear, 0, 0, okay, correct. So the boundary conditions are given. We don't have a dynamic mesh, it is a static mesh. We don't need this. Reference values, it has to compute from the inlet. Solution method, the solution scheme will be simple. So we step by the second order applying as the default says. But if you want, you can change it to second order body weighted speed. If you understand what exactly will do it, let us keep it as it is. Solution control, monitors, we don't need to monitor anything in this case. You can make do with a monitor, lift towards a CP, C, lift curve, CP curve, CD, everything you can lift, drag, everything you can monitor moment in this monitor's case. So in this case we are not monitoring it, we are going directly towards initialization, the solution, standard initialization. We will be computing from inlet. initialize. If you want some solution to be animated in case of transient, you can do it in here. Number of iteration, let me keep to 500. Reporting editor will be 1 second. Thank you. The graph in here is a residue curve. This white line is continuity as defined here. X velocity, Y green is Y velocity. So this is iteration per residue. So the solution converges at 196 point. So we have an exact solution. The solution always has to converge. So if it doesn't converge, you may just increase the number of iterations and click the calculate button. So it will proceed to a smooth number of calculations. Since the calculations are converged, we proceed towards the results part. We click the graphics and animation. We see the contours, setup, pressure, static pressure, field, display. This is how exactly it will look like. This is the velocity counters. You can match the values in your display. This red color over here depends on 2.53. So that is the stagnation part. It's blue, dark blue. We proceed towards checking the vectors. You can see how exactly the flow is moving towards it. You can just have a glance over only the cylinder wall. You can see how exactly the flow is turning towards itself. The flow separates in here and we have very less velocity. In this case, so these are the velocity vectors. We can also view path lines. for path lines and streamlines, we get parking particle ID single flash continuous. This takes a bit of a time. As you see on the screen, the path lines have been generated in here. Here's how exactly the flow is going. It goes here, turns it towards itself. Then we have four passes in, two passes in this case. You can save all these images by clicking towards File, Save Image, Save Picture, and whatever format you want, JPG, color, or grayscale, whatever it is, then click to save button and the directory. So this was about the flow over a circular cylinder. Thank you for watching it. My name is Pawan Mehta. For any queries, you can contact me. Thank you.